Good afternoon, all of you.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Okay. From tomorrow, you all are going to have your exam, half yearly exam.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Tomorrow,
yes, ma'am.
कौन सा सब्जेक्ट आ रहा है आपको कल कल
हिंदी
हिंदी
वी विल स्टार्ट विद बिफोर दैट चैप्टर 13 आई विल रिवाइज टुडे बिफोर दैट आई वांट टू टेल यू व्हाट वे यू विल प्रिपेयर फॉर योर एग्जाम फॉर योर लॉन्ग आंसर्स
आप
ना लाइट चैप्टर करोगे डायग्राम में डायग्राम उसका ड्रॉ करके देखोगे फाइव मार्क्स के क्वेश्चन के लिए ऑल द डायग्राम्स And for your long answers, weather adaptation and soil are very important. And your for chemistry, the chemical equation. But rest of the chapters, you will have objective questions and all. So all is important. All you have to study. But for the focusing, I have told you. So here we today we have the revision of chapter 13. Chapter 13, weather, climate and adaptation. Before that also I have explained chapter, but let us have a quick on the main points of this chapter. That chapter 13, weather, climate and adaptation of animals. So this weather is the state of the atmosphere at a particular time and place as well. Then there are certain elements which makes up the weather of a particular place, and that combined with so here the conditions. These conditions are your temperature, humidity. Precipitation, wind and atmospheric pressure, and these conditions are studied in a separate branch of science, and that is known as meteorology. Then, after that, we are going to deal one by one this weather elements. That how does this temperature affect the weather? So, if the temperature of a place at a particular time is less, then you will say, you can say that this the weather at that time is will can be sunny or it can be very so temperature decides the weather of a particular area or a particular place. Then humidity. What is this humidity? I have told you that before also, that it is the presence of water content in the environment, moisture content in the environment, that also has a very good impact or very prominent impact on the weather of that place. Then cloudiness. Cloudiness, why, how are the clouds affecting the weather of a place? It can be cloudy day. You will see, you can experience that it will be either very humid or it will be very, very, you can say, hot that day if the atmosphere is covered with cloud, because the heat which is generated from the earth atmosphere, that is not being allowed to escape in the environment because it is covered with the cloud. That is why it is very much having a prominent effect on the surface of the earth and the weather of a place. आप जिस दिन एक्सपीरियंस करोगे कि बहुत क्लाउडी है और आपका बारिश नहीं हो रहा है, then that temperature rises at that time. Why? Because every living being is generating carbon dioxide and just releasing energy in the environment, so that will get accumulated on the surface of the earth. Then precipitation, there are several types of precipitation in the form of rain, drizzle, snow, hail, ice, pellet and sludge. See, these are also the important factors for the deciding the weather of a particular place. Then wind, of course, जब आपका wind अच्छा blow करते रहता है तो आप देखते होंगे उस दिन आपका pleasant day रहता है और आपका maybe वो depend करता है temperature पर भी. अगर आपका hot, बहुत hot temperature है, जैसे कि हम लोग को summer season में experience करना पड़ता है, तो flu का भी form ले सकता है जो कि very hot wind होता है. That is again what? Not very pleasant, and that will affect our health also. And it can damage our environment also. But flu is not a condition in which we can have the pleasant weather. So that depends upon the temperature of that place. Then after that, atmospheric pressure. It will, if the pressure falls, then we can say that the storm will be approaching. A storm will be coming. And if the pressure is rising, then we will say that it has got clear skies and the atmosphere will be cool. Then these elements all together, when they are combinedly affecting a particular area for a longer period or a longer duration of time, then that forms your climate. वो आपका climate form करता है. और climate is different in different zones of India, and it has been divided into several zones. And what are those zones? There are four zones: alpine zone, subtropical zone, and tropical zone, and arid zone. And whole country India, it is just talking about India. We are not talking about the world. Then compare it to compare the climate, because that will be become more you can say very much complicated if we talk about the whole world over here, climate of the whole world. Then just for India only, we have to divide it into four parts, and the Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, all are your alpine zone, subtropical zone, which is then after that your tropical zone. In this tropical zone, we are having West Bengal and Assam and all, where the monsoons are. And this also tropical zone is also again divided into two types, that is tropical wet and tropical dry monsoon zones. So tropical wet monsoon zones, by the name only it is clear that it will have heavy rainfall. Usme wahan rainfall zyada hoga aur jahan par dry hoga wahan par kam hoga. So the average temperature on tropical wet monsoon zone is 18 degree centigrade, and it is high it is having a high rainfall over there. And tropical dry monsoon zone have less rainfall. Then arid zone. This arid zone is in Rajasthan, so you can just imagine generally also that the temperature of this area is very high, that is 50 degrees centigrade approximately. So it is in the western part, and it will have high temperature and low rainfall. Then according to the climate, several animals, they adapt themselves to their physical features also, through their body structure also, and through their nature also. They try to adapt a particular area or particular climate as for where they can survive easily. So here we are dividing this adaptation word into adaptation tendency of a particular animal into two categories, that is behavioral adaptation and structural adaptation. Behavioral adaptation we can see in the elephant, as they move in large herds or very in a group, so that they are getting, they feel protected over there, so that they are not being hunted by anybody, and they can be protected by the predators. They have got this polar bear has got the structural adaptation, as they are covered with thick fur because they have to survive in heavy snowy areas and very cold region in the poles. So on the pole, south pole and north pole, which is on the upper and lower side of the earth, these poles are covered with ice throughout the year. So these polar bears can survive on these poles. So this can be the structural adaptation, and there are so many factors of the polar bear according to their structure, why they are suited in this area. Then structural adaptation, we can say the camel also, because camel can survive in extreme hot condition, extreme temperature of hotness. Then after that, this polar bear, which is found in the frigid zone or very high very low temperature area, this animal is having fur like, and there are four or five conditions why they can survive over there. What are those conditions? The body temperature of polar bear is normally 37 degrees centigrade and is maintained through a thick hide, layer of fur, a tough hide, insulating layer of blubber. Then this excellent insulation keeps a polar bear warm even when the air temperature drops to minus 37 degrees. So what are the characteristics by which they can, the structural appearance or structural adaptability what they have? That is the presence of, you can say, the thick fur, that makes them in the body of a temperature of 37 degrees in minus 37 degree climatic temperature. Then they also swimming, they can close the nostril because they can swim on the underwater, which is in, just present. Singha, 7 days. Some noise is coming. At a polar bear, front paws can propel in water for swimming. It can act like a the polar bear front paws propel in the water through the water, means they can swim in the water through this front paws. And the hind feet and legs, they are flat and are used as rudders. Rudders help the to force or push the water backward so that they can just, as we have got in the sailing of the boat, you might have seen that these rudders are used so that they can be the water can be moved backward. Then this penguin is another organism, another animal, but which can live in this extreme condition, polar region. And this has got feathers with extremely dense pack with no gaps in between them. So feathers are very dense, and there are good protection. Causes a very good protection against cold. But what is that? The drawback is being a bird, but it cannot fly. This is a bird, penguin, but it cannot fly because its bones are not hollow, and they do not have light bodies. बिकॉज आप उसका फेदर जो होता है वो बहुत ही डेंसली पैक्ड होता है. व्हाई? बिकॉज दिस फेदर्स हैव टू प्रोटेक्ट दिस बर्ड इन द दिस एक्सट्रीम कंडीशन, कोल्ड कंडीशन. देन आफ्टर दैट पेंगुइन्स डू नॉट हैव एयर स्पेस as the others, other birds have, and this helps them to sink in water. They can sink in the water, and the fat layer is also there within the beneath the skin, and they have got a streamlined body. Streamlined body is tapering from both the end. एनिमल या बर्ड स्विम कर सकते हैं या फ्लाई कर सकते हैं, उनका बॉडी का एक स्ट्रक्चर होता है एंड दैट इज नोन एज स्ट्रीमलाइन्ड स्ट्रक्चर. जैसे बोट, जैसे बर्ड्स का कोई भी बर्ड ले लो, उसका बॉडी स्ट्रीमलाइन होता है. एरोप्लेन का स्ट्रक्चर को हम लोग स्ट्रीमलाइन बॉडी बोल सकते हैं बिकॉज इट इज टैपरिंग फ्रॉम बोथ द एंड. बोथ द एंड पर थोड़ा सिकुड़ा हुआ होता है जो कि कट करने में आइदर वॉटर और एयर किसी को भी कट करने में वो मदद करता है. देन द ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट, दीज आर द ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट विच आर फॉर्म नियर द इक्वेटर. इक्वेटर के पास पाया जाता है और इसमें बहुत ही डेंसली पॉपुलेटेड ये होता है प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स. बिकॉज दिस ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट आर हैविंग सफिशियंट टेम्परेचर true for this animals and birds and trees and plants to survive. And this such forest is found in India, in Malaysia, Indonesia, Brazil, Republic of Congo, Uganda and Nigeria. And the Amazon jungle is the world's largest tropical rainforest. Then this has got a temperature, average temperature of 20 to 25 degrees centigrade. Then the average temperature of the three warmest and coldest month just differs with 5 degree. Only 5 degree differentiation is there with the warm month and the cold month. And it has got a average rainfall of 2000. Millimeter every year. Then in India, these forests are found in Western Ghats and Assam, and the common animals which are found over here are monkeys, apes, gorillas, lion, lizard, tigers, elephants, leopards, snake, birds and insects. These are the animals commonly found over here. And these animals which live in the forest, they have adapted themselves to this environment, this area, their climatic conditions, and that climatic conditions of the particular area in which they are. Then adaptation by animals of tropical rainforest. Then some of the animals' names are also given. The monkeys, they have got a very particular structure. We all know that monkeys have long tail. Why this long tail? What is the benefit of the long tail? This prehensile tail helps them to hang like a hook on the branches of the tree. Then this red-eyed frog is also found in this area, and it has got a sticky surface of their legs or toes, which can stick to the branches of the leaf. The lion-tailed macaw is a unique animal which is found over here, which has got shiny black fur and a long grayish white hair around its face. And it has got a pouch in its mouth, through which it can communicate in 17 different vocal patterns. Then after that, these pouches act like the store bag, and they can keep so many food can be gathered and kept in these pouches, which is inside their mouth. And when they are leisure, when they have a free time, leisure time, then they take out this food from the pouch, and then they can just enjoy and eat it. Okay? Then after that we have got a very unique word, and that is known as toko tukan. It has got a picking in this long beak is there. You can see in the picture also on page number 206 that it is having a beautiful beak, and it is 20 centimeter long. It's very beautiful. And a black spot, orange beak with a black spot. You can imagine that how beautifully it can it is made, and it can scoop the water. It can drink, means it can just suck the water from the fruits and eat the fruit as well. Means the nectar or the juice which is present in the fruit, it can scoop it. Then big cat like lion, tiger, leopard, they are used as predators, and they are also found in this tropical rainforest. And they have got teeth. Is that like teeth? Rishabh Raj, don't disturb the class. Is that like teeth which can help them to tear the flesh in the dark? Now, after that, the elephant. Elephant is, children, a very unique, you can say, animal which can survive or which can be present in the herds, and it has got so many important parts like the trunk, the tusk, and the trunk is made up of 150,000 muscles, and it acts like a hand. They can use it for grasping low ground shrubs and food material and placing them in the mouth. They can use this trunk for squirting water on their body. Then they can, while they are inside the water, they just keep their trunk on the upper surface of the water so that the water cannot enter and they do not get some inside the water. So they have keep it their body floating on the surface of the water. They can float and they can breathe also. And this tusk is also a very important factor. The two long teeth, which is just a teeth which is not used for chewing or eating, it is just for show, and it can, but it can, has got a very unique type of eyes. It's not such a giant animal, but the eyes are very small, and the nostril which enables them to detect the odor. It has got poor eyesight. It cannot see very long because you just see it is a huge animal, but the eyes are very small. Then it can, it has got a flap like ear which can observe or which can see hear the sound from a longer distance, which can collect the sound waves through that flap like ears also. Okay, so this children, this is all in this chapter. Is chapter mein aapko itna hi hai jo main point hai, aur rest of the question answers which have all, which I have already discussed, aur jo aapke paas hoga bhi likha hua, usse aap log isko kar lijiyega. Okay, so for today we have and from tomorrow I need to have your exam, so you will be involved in the exam. So in science, I think it is on 24th. I just want that all of you should do well. पीछे का chapter, पीछे का question answer पढ़ने के बाद chapter को भी जरूर कर लीजिए, ठीक है? And answer your questions early. Be alert in answering. और आप लोग को कुछ अगर पूछना है तो पूछ लो. Anything you want to ask?
अरे ऊपर ऑफिस में जाओ. नहीं देखो ना बहुली. अरे बैक तो बाहर.
Anything?
मैं what is drizzle?
Drizzle. ड्रिजल, जैसे आप कभी कभी फुहारा पड़ते नहीं देखे हो, बारिश जब होता है तो बहुत तेज बारिश, हल्का हल्का छोटा छोटा ड्रॉप्स फुहारा बोलते हैं, तो दैट इज नोन एज ड्रिजल। ड्रिजल सब सब जो आइस पेलेट्स, ड्रिजल, स्नो, ये सब ही वेराइटी ऑफ द वॉटर ड्रॉपलेट्स एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द साइज ऑफ द वॉटर ड्रॉपलेट्स विच आर बींग कमिंग फ्रॉम द क्लाउड्स और फ्रॉम द स्काई जो फॉल करता है। जैसे जब वो तेज बारिश होती है, मतलब बहुत नॉर्मल कंडीशन में तुम वॉटर ड्रॉपलेट्स देख सकते हो, उसको हम लोग रेन बोलते हैं। जब थोड़ा हल्का फुहारा होता है तो उसको ड्रिजल बोलते हैं। स्नो तो जानते हो, स्नोफॉल होता है जहाँ बहुत लो टेम्परेचर होता है, वहाँ एक कंडीशन ऐसा आता है जहाँ की आपको बर्फ का गोला दिखेगा। और आइस पिलेट्स हम लोग के बिहार में भी कभी कभी होता है, छोटा छोटा टुकड़ा आइस का गिरता है, समय बोलते होंगे हम लोग बोलते हैं उसको बर्फ गिरा है ना, या ओला पड़ा जिसको
ओला
डैमेजिंग होता है हमारे इसके लिए क्रॉप्स के लिए, ठीक है, क्योंकि वो क्या करता है, हर्ट करता है, दैट हर्ट्स योर क्रॉप एंड मेक्स इट फॉल अगेन, वो सॉइल में फिर से उसको फॉल करने के लिए, तो हमारा यील्ड क्या होगा, उससे बर्बाद हो जाता है ना, तो दैट आर आइस। तो यही है अलग अलग वेराइटी ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेशन विच इज, ठीक है। और कुछ एल्स एनीबॉडी, कोई दिक्कत है तो पूछ लो आप लोग, सृष्टि कोई भी चैप्टर, नॉट दिस चैप्टर ओनली, कोई भी चैप्टर से पूछ लो। और रे डायग्राम आई एम टेलिंग यू अगेन एंड अगेन, रे डायग्राम अच्छे से प्रैक्टिस कर लेना चैप्टर लाइट का, और इसका जो लॉन्ग आंसर है ना उसको भी लर्न कर लेना, सॉइल और इसका लॉन्ग आंसर। और कुछ, एनीथिंग मोर यू वांट टू आस्क? ओके, सो लेट अस स्टॉप द क्लास देन। थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू।
थैंक यू मैम।
थैंक यू मैम।
थैंक यू मैम।
Have a nice day, ma'am.
Ma'am, can the long answer questions come
next,
in part?
Your exams, okay? Thank you.
Have a nice day, ma'am.